the Holy Gospel according to St. John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God still and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If there were not, I should have told you. I am going now to prepare a place for you. And after I have gone and prepared you a place, I shall return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. You know the way to the place where I am going." And Thomas said, "Lord, we do not know the way where you are going, so how do we know the way?" And Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Elijah Michael James Humphries, now in God's care, on the 13th of August 2007, aged 3.5 years, precious son of Julie and Darren, specially loved brother of Francesca, loved grandson of Colleen, Ted and Novena, Raymond and the late Julia, loved nephew of Bernadette and James, Serena and Peter, Annie, Christine and Bob, loved cousin of Mitchell and Logan, Jethro, Jabez and Josiah, and loved by all great aunties, uncles and extended family and members of the Lamb of God community. This is how you, Julie and Darren, announced to the world the passing of your loved son. And last night you gathered with your friends in the Lamb of God to continue to express your sympathy and bereavement and feelings of loss, as you related this in terms of your own personal faith in Jesus Christ, the Lord and lover of life. And so today we gather on his burial day here in his parish church to commit him finally to God in this Requiem Eucharist. Spring is just around the corner. Sometimes in spring you will come across an apple blossom lying on the ground, having been brought down by a shower of hail or a gust of wind. We're tempted to say, "What a pity it died so soon. It would have made splendid apples." And to speak like that is simply to imply that the whole worth of that blossom always lay in the future, a future from which we have been irrevocably cut off. But of course that is not true. The point is that the blossom has lived, even for only a short while. And it has accomplished something. During its brief life, it has perfumed the sweet air of life. It has brought beauty, it has brightened the earth. Moreover, its existence signaled the arrival of spring. And that's no small achievement. What it would have become is not the point. The point is that it was a perfect blossom. What more could anyone ask? Darren and Julie, your child dies. And we're inclined to say with you, what a pity he died before he was able to bear fruit. In other words, we speak of promise rather than of achievement. And that's unfair to Elijah today. The most important thing about Elijah is not what he might have achieved, but the fact that he was. So instead of grieving for what might have been, it would be better to be thankful for what has been. But in fact, Elijah did achieve something and left a beautiful store of memories to treasure. And to endure what he endured, and then to die so calmly and so bravely, is to have achieved a great deal. It's the equivalent of living to a ripe old age.